It's such a cool way to evaluate this series right here. And you see, this sum right here is basically deeply connected to our Riemann zeta function and our Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. That video was quite overkill, but yeah. We're going to evaluate this simple infinite series today. At least I think it's quite easy to evaluate. And what I'm going to show you now is actually the first way I ever calculated this thing on my own. And it's pretty damn overkill if you ask me, using double integrals on the unit square, blah, blah, blah. But it's really quite cool, so bear with me right here. Maybe I have derived this already using pure algebra, but I don't know. Maybe that video comes after that. I don't have an upload schedule at all. This right here takes inspiration from my Basel problem integral representation on the unit square thing. And at first I want to give some inspiration where this idea comes from. I would like to take a look at the integral of, well, x to the nth power. Okay, if you integrate this, you're going to end up with x to the n plus 1 power over n plus 1. Okay, I hope you agree with me simply integrating polynomials right here. And if you evaluate this thing from 0 to 1, well, you are basically just going to get 1 over n plus 1. Okay, if you take a look at this thing right here, we have 2k plus 1 squared down here. So this is 2k plus 1 times 2k plus 1. Meaning, if we interpret this as just polynomials being integrated, we're going to get an infinite sum, an infinity boy. Of, okay, let's see, we have x to the 2k plus 1 power times t to the 2k plus 1 power over 2k plus 1 squared. Evaluated x being equal to 0 to 1, okay? So this is just our boundary conditions, and t from 0 to 1. I hope you agree with me, so this is just simple backwards engineering, you could say. Now, like I said, we can put this into integral terms, meaning we are going to get just a sum running from k equals to 0 to infinity. And, well, this stuff right here is basically nothing but, okay, so we have an integral from 0 to 1 over t, for example. So this is nothing but t to the 2k power dt, and then times an integral from 0 to 1, x to the 2k, to the 2k power dx. Okay, pretty damn easy. So I guess all of you can see where this came from. We can Fubini this shit. You guys just love when I say this. Meaning, well, those integrands are strictly positive. This sum right here converges absolutely, blah, 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 and uniformly probably. So we can just bring this together to a double integral. Also, we can bring this infinite sum to the inside of everything. Meaning, overall, after an interchanging limit, we are going to end up with an integral t being equal to 0 to 1 to x 0 to 1 of an infinite sum running from k equals to 0 to infinity of, okay, we can collect terms because they have the same power, so this is nothing but t times x to the 2k power dt dx. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, it's just as easy as this. What is this? Tx to the 2k power is nothing but t times x squared to the k power. Okay, let's put parentheses out here to the kth power. And then voila, on this interval, well, t times x squared is between 0 and 1, so we can turn this into the geometric series, leaving us with an integral from 0 to 1. An integral from 0 to 1 of 1 over 1 minus t times x squared, integrated with respect to t, integrated with respect to x. Isn't that cool? So we have turned this into something pretty easy. Now we can do partial fraction decomposition, and it's going to be really quite easy. Because down here in the denominator, we have the difference of two squares. Meaning, we are going to use partial fraction decomposition of 1 minus t times x 1 plus t times x, and now you little smart asses in the comments are going to comment, oh, you can see this at a glance, I'm watching Black Pill, Red Pill, I'm smart as fuck, I know how to math. Go F yourself, please. We are going to do partial fraction decomposition. Yes, we are going to do it. You can go F yourself, my boys and girls out there. I love you, just don't be smart asses. I'm just trying to do my thing here, okay? A is nothing but 1/2, but that's the same thing as B. So we have a common factor of 1/2 that we can bring to the outside. We have turned this into partial fractions, so that's pretty cool. So we are going to get 1/2 times the double integral, both from 0 to 1 on the unit square, and then we have 1 over 1 minus t times x plus 1 over 1 plus t times x integrated with respect to t integrated with respect to x. I hope this wasn't too fast for you guys. That's just easy algebra right here. It's nothing special. It's something a first grader could probably do. Now, if our integral overall does exist, we can break this up using the linearity of the integral into two integrals. Meaning, we are going to get 1/2 times a double integral from 0 to 1 of, okay, this is 1 over 1 minus t times x dt dx plus 1/2 double integral. Okay, I'm going to put a little line right here, just that it doesn't distract from what we are doing now up here, okay? So this is 1 over 1 plus t times x dt dx. Like I said, it's a bit overkill, this method, but it's pretty damn cool. I don't want to go into too much detail about this one right here, because we have derived it before. This is nothing but, well, theta of 2, which is nothing but pi squared over 6. So this is going to give us pi squared over 12 overall. We are going to take a look at this thing right here. It's a slight variant of what we had right here. Spoiler alert, it's the Dirichlet eta function. See you in a second. So this video in itself is already quite cool, because we are going to derive an actual integral representation somehow of the Dirichlet eta function evaluated at 2, probably 10. It's kind of like an alternating Riemann theta function, you could say. We could probably see at a glance what this is going to evaluate to, because we have kind of derived it before in this Putnam axiom variant video, but never mind. What we won't do, you see, 1 plus t times x is nothing but 1 minus negative t times x, okay? And this looks hella like our geometric series, boy. And on this interval, everything does converge with respect to t and with respect to x. Never mind, we don't really give a shit about anything, so we just turn this into the geometric series. So let's call this thing right here just I, okay? Meaning, our I is nothing but an integral from 0 to 1. Integral from 0 to 1 of, okay, this is going to give us an infinite sum, running from 0 to infinity, infinity boy, negative t times x to the kth power dt dx. We have negative 1 right here, so we can bring it to the outside. Also, we are just going to interchange this infinite sum, and those limits right here, we really don't care, giving us our infinity boy back. From 0 to infinity, negative 1 to the kth power. Also, we are going to have integral from 0 to 1, integral from 0 to 1, t times x to the kth power dt dx. And now you can Fubini this shit once again. So break this up into two separate integrals, integrate those polynomials, evaluate those at the limits. So this thing right here is basically going to evaluate to t to the k plus 1 power over k plus 1 times x to the k plus 1 power over k plus 1, and both of those from 0 to 1 evaluated. At 0 it's going to vanish, it's just a polynomial, never mind that. Okay, and at 1 it's just going to be this down here, so k plus 1 squared. So overall I is going to evaluate to sum running from k equals to 0 to infinity of negative 1 to the kth power over k plus 1 squared. I don't want to talk too much about child's play like this, so you can take a piece of paper and try it out for yourself. We came pretty far on this channel already, so I really don't care about any little small steps right here anymore. You can make a little change of index, for example, let n be equal to k plus 1, meaning our new sum would then run from n equals to 1 to infinity, negative 1 to the n plus 1th power over n squared. And this thing right here, like I said, is nothing but, if I remember correctly, eta of 2. It's going to vary to something we have found out together with the Bessel problem in one very video back then. It's nothing but pi squared over 12, okay? So take a look into the description, there will be a link to the corresponding video. Meaning, overall, this thing right here is nothing but, okay, this sum, I'm going to put it here as the last little note, as the Gucci little thing at the end. Our infinite sum that we wanted to find out is nothing but 1 half times pi squared over 6 is nothing but pi squared over 12. And then we have 1 half times pi squared over 12 is nothing but positive pi squared over 24. We can advance or expand this fraction by 2 over 2, giving us 2 pi squared over 24. Overall giving us 3 pi squared over 24 in the natural numbers. You can trust the Peano axioms if you want, as always. This is nothing but 3 times 8. Canceling this out leaves us with our desired result, that this is nothing but pi squared over 8. I thank you guys for watching. For me, it feels a bit rushed, actually, so maybe I should have toned it down a little bit, but never mind. We arrived at the result that we wanted to get. It's such a cool way to evaluate this series right here. And you see, this sum right here is basically deeply connected to our Riemann zeta function and our our sum that we had right here is pretty connected to our Riemann zeta function and our Dirichlet eta function right here. This way. What a nice speech, Papa Flemmy. You are so eloquent. So that's pretty cool. I'm going to derive this algebraically too. Maybe I did that already. If you did enjoy this video, please like and subscribe and recommend the channel if you like. If you want to support the channel, click on those Quora questions I post from time to time. Buy those t-shirts I created. This one is so cool. Or support the channel on Patreon. Whatever you do, I thank you guys for watching. Up until the next video, have a flammable day. See ya.